Hi, this is part two of the Dancing Star animation series. Before we start the next layer, click on the reset button in Styles and reset all tools by clicking on the icon up here and choosing Reset All Tools. In the Layers palette, click on the New Layer icon and choose Vector. Name this Stars. Go to Tools. Click on the Draw Shape icon, and up here, choose the star. In the Styles, next to Fill, click on that swatch, and choose a color that you like. I'm going to pick a yellow, and click OK. Or you could just use the swatches and choose a color that you like in there for your stars. And then I'll click and drag, and draw a star. Now if I zoom in, you'll see that my star has the thick black outline, and you may not like that. If we go and look underneath Fill and click on Select Shape and click once on the star, we can change the width of that stroke line by changing the number. It's a 4 right now. I could change it to a 2 and hit Enter. I can also use the mouse wheel. And you can see there on the screen, the thickness is changing. I might also prefer to click on this stroke swatch and change it to something that more closely matches that yellow. So you can see that mine is a little bit darker, okay, but it doesn't look quite as stark as the difference between a black and a yellow. And click OK. Now I'm zooming back out. Now I can continue to make more stars by going over here to Tools, clicking on the Draw Shape icon and the star icon, and then drawing out several stars all over the place. And they can be different sizes. Keep in mind we are going to have one main star character in the middle. Leave room for that later on a separate layer. The other thing you can do is choose the oval up here, and then I'm going to hold down my Shift key and draw very small circles. Again, I'll have to zoom in so you can see that. And that can be a more distant stars that don't have that traditional star shape. Now I'm going to pause the video and work on my stars a little bit, and why don't you do the same, and I'll return and we'll work on the next object. Okay, so I've returned now, and just to remind you about where we're headed, we're going to work on that moon surface next. In the Layers palette, click on the New Layer icon and choose Vector and name this Moon. Click on the Reset button in the Style menu. You want to clear these colors from here. So click Reset. Click the Reset All Tools. You'll want to see a little bit more of the bottom of the workspace below the stage. Over here, click on this hand icon. And then push the left mouse button and move that up about to there. Underneath Tools, click on the Draw Shape icon and choose the oval. And then point your mouse approximately here and click and drag until you get a shape that looks about like that. Then you can reset this by clicking here on the Zoom tool and choosing Reset View button right here. Now let's edit the moon. Underneath Fill, click on Select Shape, and click on that shape. And over here under Style, we can take off the stroke, or you can leave yours on. And you want to choose a color for your moon. I'm going to go with a gray, which I'm choosing here from the swatches. You can use this if you want and find a color in there. I'm going to click once here in a blank area of the workspace just so I can see that better. So you see, I don't care for that dark outline, and I can change that if I reselect the shape by clicking once on it, and next to stroke, I could change that to something that matches better so that it isn't black on gray, and then click OK. Now we're going to apply an effect. So if yours is not selected, be sure that you have the select shape icon and that you've clicked once and that you see that checkerboard effect there. And then next to effect, click on the drop down and choose shaded. I'm going to move this out of the way so that we can see better. We can see a sample of the shading right here, and we can move this shadow around by clicking on this dial, and then you can see it moving here too. You can also click here in this field and you can roll your mouse wheel. Okay. Under offset, if you click in here and then move your mouse wheel, you can see that this changes the positioning of that shadow. And next is blur. Again, if you click in this field and you wheel your mouse around, then you can see that it gets softer, or wheeling it the other way, and it looks sharper. So you can adjust that however you want. And when you're done, click OK. If you decide to change it later, again, with that shape selected, you can just click here on this square with the three dots, and you get right back into that dialog box again. I'm going to click once over here to deselect that, and then I can see that I have a little bit of shading on my moon surface. Now we can keep those settings for the moon craters and just make some adjustments. Go over to the Layers palette, click on the new layer icon and choose Vector, and name this Craters. Now go over to Tools, click on the Draw Shape icon, choose the Oval tool, and draw a small oval right here. And then let's have a look at this by rendering out a single frame. And remember, on your keyboard, that's Control R. All right, so I can see that I probably want to make some changes to it before I make more craters. So I'll close this. Now I'm going to zoom in so that I can see this better. And then in Tools under Fill, click on Select Shape and click on that crater. And then I'm going to make the fill and the stroke a little darker. And I also probably need to make this stroke line narrower for that crater, because that was pretty fat. So I'm changing my fill color to be darker than the moon and clicking OK. And then the stroke swatch, I'll click in there and make this a little bit darker too. Click OK. And then the stroke width, I probably only want to be maybe 2. And then I hit Enter. And now I'm going to do Control R again. So that looks a little better, but I'm going to change the shading too. So next to Effect, there's Shading. I'll click on the three dots. And now I think I won't make that as soft, so I'm going to change the blur. And the offset looks wrong, so I'm moving that. And maybe I'll change my light angle. So you can see that I've just made little adjustments all through here, and I watched while I was doing it. And then when you're happy with yours, click OK. And if you need to pause the video and work on it, you can do that. I'll zoom back out, clicking the zoom tool, choosing Reset View. Now I can go back and click on Draw Shape, And now I'll make more craters of different sizes. Some can hang below the stage area. That'll make it look even better. Okay. And I will do Control R and render a sample again. So I'll close this. If you need to make some adjustments to the placements of your crater, just go over here underneath Draw and click on the Transform Points tool right here. And then you can click on a crater individually and then move it. So why don't you work on that? I'm going to pause and fix mine up a little bit, and I'll continue in the next video.